Be content with what you have. Be content with being with Jesus. Trust in the Lord. Do we believe that God can get us through anything? Anything. You know, it's really hard to get people to have that trust. It is. It's hard. It's not saying, hey, this is easy. It's hard. It's a lesson to be learned. But to trust in the Lord, to know that He gets through this, as He said, the amount of people that give their lives to Christ, once those words come through, you have cancer. Because there's nowhere to turn. They're not sure they have faith in the doctors. They're not sure they have faith in the chemotherapy. They're not sure they have faith. And to me, to be honest, in every aspect of our life, I'm not sure about anything. There's nowhere to turn on anything except for God. Oh, yeah? What the world's going through, the way people treat each other, the way people act, there's no one to turn but God. And I'm sure much rather turn to the Creator of the universe, who sent His Son to die on a cross for me, and His Son didn't stay dead. On the third day, He rose from the dead. And all the miracles that He performed, I would sure rather trust in that than a couple of $100 bills. Oh, yeah? And we have to get that place in our faith. And the question comes down is, can you trust Jesus? Can you trust Jesus? Can you think about, well, with what's going on with my finances and everything that's happening, can I trust Jesus to take care of this? Or, you know, do I need to worry about this? Or do I need to do this? And I can't tell you, when I was with Kmart, the amount of people that I went to a store and their refunds were out of control in up around Cleveland. And I said, there's no way that you're refunding all this merchandise. And I said, bring me the security manager. And I said, have you looked at these reports? And he said, not really. And I said, you're 20% of your sales are refunds when the corporate average is 6. I said, I want a camera on the service desk. And they called me in and they said, Mr. Brown, we caught this lady and she's doing fake refunds and stealing money like crazy. I sat down and I said, why are you stealing money? And she broke down crying, and we found out that her mother had Alzheimer's and they put her in a nursing home and they wouldn't pay for it. The insurance companies wouldn't pay anything. And her husband couldn't live taking care of him at home. And instead of trying to trust God and turn to the church and all the different angles, the first thing that hit her was theft. To steal. You know, there was an old question, if your family was starving, would you steal a loaf of bread? The correct answer is no. I would go to God's people and see what they would do for me. Oh, yeah? You see, there's always things that God will do. It's just that when it gets really tough, do we trust Him? And He is always there for us. And when we look back in history, we can see how He's been there over and over and over. And we should learn to build that trust and have no fear of what happens to our money, but put all of our faith in what God will provide. If you want that in your life, we offer an invitation today where you come and just tell God you want that kind of trust in your life. You want that relationship with Jesus. It's where you learn not to worry about things because it's just unreal how He'll help. And we offer that invitation while they sing, please stand.